What's cracking? I know I'm looking very business chic today. I don't know why, that's just what I was feeling today. Anyways, this is my second time filming this video because the first time I made it, I was just acting so odd. I never know where to film in my room anymore, so I always just resort back to my floor. Why do I look so pale? Because I am. Oh, Christ. Anyways, today's video, I just wanted to do like a quick little non-sponsored video about skincare and skincare products. I've mentioned my story with my skin, I guess, and how I used to not have the best skin, and now it's not too bad, and it's been clear for a while. Is my skin perfect? No. Am I perfect? Sometimes. Good skin is not in my genetics whatsoever, so I have definitely had my fair share of really good skincare products that I just would like to share with you. Yeah, like I said, this video is not sponsored whatsoever. I have been sponsored by some of these brands that I'm going to mention. This video is not sponsored. I don't do sponsored videos unless I genuinely like the brand. With that being said, let's get started. I have all my notes on my little iPad right here. The first thing that I wanted to talk about is face wash or like cleansers. I have three different ones I have been using, like switching back and forth, that I really love. They are all from the same brand, but like I said, this video is not sponsored. So the first one that I really like is the CNC by Clean and Clear Chill Out Cooling Mint Pore Cleanser. But you can get this at Ulta. It's $12. It's vegan. Like I said, $12, very affordable. The reason that I really like this is because of the like after effect that it leaves on your face. It has that really cooling effect, so it feels like your skin is actually genuinely clean. It gets all of your makeup off. I hate having to use multiple things to get my makeup off. I just barely ran out of this not too long ago, but I am looking to purchase it again. The second one is also from CNC by Clean and Clear. It's the charcoal cleansing bar. This is $8. It's also vegan and cruelty-free. I use this when my face feels super dirty. I feel like it does a really good job of like cleaning out my pores. I have a lot of like big pores on my nose, and so I like rub that directly on my nose, and I feel like it does a good job of cleaning it. This is what I've been using pretty recently right now. Definitely recommend that one as well. The next one, I just barely found out that this is a moisturizer. I thought it was a toner. I don't know why, because it's foam. I don't think foam toners are a thing. The last face wash that I really love is the Total Zen Lavender Mousse Cleanser. This is $12, also vegan, from the same brand. I like lavender, so I like how this is. I feel like it's a lot more gentle on my skin, so if I just want something a little bit lighter, then I will use this. But yeah, this makes my skin feel really clean. I like lavender, and I also like that it's mousse, so it's like a different texture. Those are my top three face washes that I really enjoy using. The next little section is moisturizer. The first one that I like is, of course, from the same brand. I haven't used this in a while because I ran out of it, but I know that I really did like it. I had two different bottles and I ran out of both of them. So this is the Don't Flake Gel Moisturizer. This is $16, vegan, also cruelty free. I really like gel moisturizers compared to like actual the lotion, like cream textures. I don't know why, I just really like the way that it feels on my skin. It doesn't feel super like sticky after or anything like that. So that's the first one. The second one is very similar to the first one because it's also like that gelish texture. It's the MyClarins Reboost Refreshing Hydrating Cream. This is also vegan and $25, so this is more than the other one, but they are very similar. So if you're like looking for a dupe to this, which I'm sure no one really is, I don't know, but the CNC by Clean and Clear one is very similar. I need to go out and buy another moisturizer, and I think if I went out and bought one, I would get the CNC by Clean and Clear one. But yeah, I do really like this one too. They actually sent me this in a PR package, and I really enjoy a lot of their other products. The next thing for moisturizing I like to use is Vaseline. No, I don't put this all over my face, because that would just be kind of gross. I use Vaseline when it comes to like dry patches or on my lips. For some reason recently, like up around my nose has been super dry, so I've been putting Vaseline there, and I feel like it has been working. I don't have oily skin. I have super, super dry skin, so I have to make sure that I have good moisturizers. I don't believe that this is vegan. I tried to do my research on it, but because it's like petroleum gel, I don't think that's vegan. I'll leave the link down below that I was like reading this from. I don't know how credible it is. I also read that it doesn't test on animals, so I am hoping that that's true. So yeah, you can literally get Vaseline from anywhere. The one that I have is like the big tub. It's like less than $4. So yeah, I have Vaseline on my lips right now because my lips get super, super dry literally all year long. So I like to use Vaseline a lot for that. The next little section is toners. I don't use toner super often, but the one that I do have, I really like. It's the CNC by Clean and Clear Tough Love Acne Peppermint Clearing Toner. This is $12, also vegan. I really like this because it has the same effect that the mint cleanser that I was talking about earlier, how it leaves your skin feeling super, super like cool, you know? That feeling when it just feels super like cool, like kind of how mouthwash like leaves your mouth when it's like the mint flavor, but like not as extreme obviously, because that would probably like hurt if your face felt like that. But yeah, this is really good for acne. I use this a lot, but when I do use it, I focus it mainly on my chin because I usually get like little just spots down there. So this is really good for acne. That's all the toners that I use and have like ever used really. But speaking of acne, the next little section is acne. So for my skin, I never had like, I don't even know how to explain it. I'll put like some pictures right here that I can find. I never had like acne, but my skin just wasn't clear. I just had little red bumps, especially up on my forehead. I had them everywhere, but they weren't super like prominent zits, but I do still get like just single big zits every now and then. I just had one up here and I use a few things to clear it or make it go away. First product I have in the little acne section is the BioClarity Treat Complexion Perfection. It's a spot treatment. So this is better if you just get like single zits compared to like having them more all over. This is what I use to clear the zit that I had over here. I just use a tiny bit, put it on my skin at night, and I use that for about like 2 or 3 days and it was gone. This goes for $19.95. I believe BioClarity is all vegan. Yeah, I really like BioClarity. They've sponsored me before and I'm doing another sponsorship with them later. The next thing that I want to talk about is Curology. This is a monthly subscription. It's $19.95 plus $4.95 shipping and handling. They send you a bottle monthly. This sounds like such a sponsorship, but it's not. I just genuinely really like Curology. It was the thing that really like turned my skin around and kept it clear for like a long time. So I did do a deal with them, and so they sent me 6 bottles for 6 months. That is now over, and I just recently repurchased it with my own money. If you guys want to do more research on Curology, then you can. They have like specific bottles just for you. Okay, moving on. The next thing that I have is another little like spot treatment type thing. It's the Peace Out Skincare Peace Out Acne Healing Dots. These are $19. The ones that I have, I think, are $19, but you can get smaller or bigger pack. It's another spot treatment that I really like. Besides, instead of like a cream or something, it's like an actual little dot thing that you put on your thing and leave it on overnight, and then you peel it off the next morning. I don't know. I feel like they just get the job done. I don't have too much to say about those. The next section is masks. I am not a huge face mask person, but I never really have been. The one mask that I actually wrote down, it's not even really a mask because it's not something that you like put on and then like peel off, and it's not like a sheet mask, but it's the MyClarins Recharge Sleep Mask. It's basically just a moisturizer. It just says mask in the title, so I'm considering it a mask, but this is $27. It's very similar to the moisturizer. If nighttime had a smell, like, it would be this. I don't know the science behind it, and I don't know if it's something that I'm like tricking myself into, but I genuinely feel like it helps me fall asleep because it is like a sleep mask. But I don't know if you guys have any good masks. I'm sure like Lush masks are good. I've used like Sephora sheet masks before and they're great. They don't really do anything for acne, but I feel like they're good with hydrating your face and they're not super expensive. But I don't know, I've never used a face mask where I'm like, wow, my face feels really good after using it. So if you have any, let me know and other people know down below. The next section is lips. I think taking care of your lips is just important as taking care of your actual skin. I have a few chapsticks and glosses that I really like. The first one is Burt's Bees. I've been using Burt's Bees since I literally came out of the womb. My grandma always has Burt's Bees on deck. I like the minty feeling that it leaves, but the thing with Burt's Bees is they have so many different flavors of chapstick. So a 4-pack for Burt's Bees, because you need more than one. You need one like in your bag, in your like school bag, by your bed, and like by your sink. I don't know. A 4-pack is $10.99. I think it's a good deal. The next thing is kind of like a mix between like a gloss and a chapstick. It's the Ohai lip jellies. I think that's what they're called. One of these is $8, so they're a little bit more expensive. This stays on your lips literally all day, which I really like. I can put it on in the morning before school, and usually like about when I go home, it's like kind of just barely started wearing off. This does last long, in my opinion. Next thing is the GlossierBalm.com. These are a little bit more expensive. These are $12 for one, I believe. I have only used one of these, and it's the mint one. A lot of people like the birthday cake one, but birthday cake flavor literally makes me gag. I feel like this has a lot more product in it. I don't know. But yeah, I really like these. I like the flavor of it. I feel like this also stays on my lips for a really long time, but it is kind of expensive just for like a chapstick. The last thing I use on my lips is Vaseline, like I said earlier. Okay, moving on to the very last thing. This other category is just called other because it doesn't really fit into any of the other categories. The first thing is the Glossier sunscreen. I don't know what is so good about this sunscreen, but I love it. It's $25. I know that's a little much for a sunscreen, and the bottle isn't super big. I like the way that it smells. It doesn't have color, so it doesn't leave any like white residue on your face. I really don't know what it is, but I really like it. It's also vegan. Sunscreen is super important. I know so many people that have like had skin cancer just from not wearing sunscreen. sunscreen. Be safe when you're out in the sun. The next thing is the BioClarity Chlorophyll. This is $19.95. Basically what it is it's a product that has a bunch of chlorophyll in it. It's really good for your skin. It's green. It doesn't leave your face green. It's supposed to cancel out redness, which I feel like it does a pretty good job of. This light is so bright and I look so pale. I promise I'm not actually that pale. It's not like a moisturizer. It's kind of just like a hydrating type thing. I've been using it a lot recently and I really like it. It's not really like an acne thing. I don't know. I just feel like it's good for my skin, so I use it. The next two things I got in a PR package when I was like doing my research of these products. I had no idea how expensive they were, but they are pretty expensive, but I do still like them and I use them every day, so I thought I would include them anyway. The first thing is the, I think it's pronounced Obagi. I'm not exactly sure. Obagi Rejuvenating Serum. It's $95. That is so expensive for one little skincare product. I really do like it and I use it every day, but I would not go out and probably purchase it again, even though I do like it and I use it every day. It makes my skin feel super, super dewy and I really like it. Usually I'll like wash my face and then put that on and then put moisturizer on after that because it says to follow it with either moisturizer or sunscreen. I was looking at Sephora, I think, and it didn't say anything about it being vegan, but it did say that it was cruelty-free. Next thing is from the same brand. It's the Vitamin C Serum. This is like one of those little dropper things where you like drop it all over your face. This is $90 for a little bottle of serum. I like it. I don't know. I feel like it's been good to my skin, but would I go out and buy it again? Probably not, just because of the price, but if it was cheaper, I probably would because I really like it. The last two products that I really like are different types of makeup wipes. So the first one is the Simple Skin Cleansing Wipes. These are $6. I believe these are vegan. I've used makeup wipes before, the Burt's Bees ones, and I feel like they just don't get the job done, but these ones do. They get all my makeup off and they make my skin feel clean after. Same thing with the CNC by Clean & Clear So Wipe Tropical Face Wipes. These ones smell really good. As the name shows, they have like a tropical smell and they smell good. They get my makeup off. I don't use makeup wipes super often because when I want to get my makeup off, I just wash it all off. The Clean & Clear ones are $8, so they're like $2 more than the other ones, but I like them both. They both do the job, and I've also said that way too many times. That was all for this video. I hope it helped. I genuinely love and use all of these products. No, I don't use every single one of these products every night. It just depends on what I'm feeling and what my skin is feeling like. You get the gist. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope this video was helpful. If you guys have any more products that you would like to either recommend to me or recommend to you guys, leave them down below. I will have links to every single one of these products mentions down below. But yeah, I don't really have any active zits right now. I do have a little bit of redness around my nose and always down here, but other than that, it's not too bad. So yeah, here's what my skin looks like right now. Anyways, I genuinely love these products. I feel like they work and they have helped me clear my skin. Thank you for watching. Peace out. Bye. Mwah.